And we are back here at White Mountains today. We have esteemed guest Doug Garland from Bear Notch Ski Touring Center. Good morning, Doug. How are you?
Good morning. Very good.
It's been a while. Have I even seen you yet this winter?
No. This is the first time.
Because you've been out grooming.
Yeah.
It's been a crazy winter, like early, lots of snow, and then a little bit of a dry spell, and then rain and snow. And what I like to talk about Bear Notch is that you guys are very extremely dedicated to the grooming, the science of it, and having the experience to do it. So let's talk about the network in general, and then we'll get into what you guys have been doing to make sure these conditions are what they are.
Well, the network in general, you know, we have an awful lot of really nice scenic and simple terrain, and that's great for beginners. Mm. So we always can get people out there, even first timers, out to the Saco River and down through that area there. And as we expand out into the network, we have some really fun intermediate skiing.
Yes.
And then we go into the Black Diamonds, you know. So and the experts like the Black Diamonds. But right now, we're concentrating on the intermediate and beginner trails today.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So we had, you know, a lot of North Conway and the surrounding areas up into Bartlett. So a little bit of rain. How do you deal with that when you're heading out grooming? Because I know you guys are out there all hours of the night just to make sure the conditions, because I was reading the report, it looks phenomenal today.
And it will be. We're going to end up being, it's going to be a quality over quantity day today. So we'll go over it as many times as it takes to make it a fantastic ski. Mm-hmm. And as we always said, we'd rather see something nice twice.
Right.
You know, so that's the way it goes.
Okay.
And so today we're going to be out there. We've been out there all night, actually.
But
when it gets wet, you'll have a challenge, and this is where it really comes in important. You have to hit it at the exact right time, and everything sets up around the same time, so you can only get certain portions done. Mm. So, you know, we hit it once lightly, then it resets up again. Mm-hmm. Then you hit it again, and it pulverizes a little bit. Before you're done, you end up with this nice little machine-groomed powder granular mix,
which
skiers are amazed with it.
I was going to say, is that a fast or slow ski? How does that play out?
It's a faster ski, but it's a very controllable ski because you've got plenty of material to work with.
Ah.
It's a very fun ski is what it is.
Nice.
Because dry powder can be a little bit slow. But this has all the qualities of powder, but it still has a little bit of speed to it. So most people like that better.
Yeah, so deep tracks, nice corduroy to deal with.
Yeah.
And you guys, I mentioned you were out all night, and you and your brother passing each other in the night, you in the light machine, and him heading out with
heading
a big piston bully.
And that's the one that's our real ace in the hole, because he has what we call the renovator on the front of that and a tiller on the back of it. And this winter, that has been so important because we've been on the roller coaster of warm, cold, warm, cold, warm, cold. And what that does is it really just is amazing.
Mm.
Even last week, we had, you know, some challenging conditions. People came up. Our base is in such good shape, people can't believe it. I got two hugs last week. People came out of their way last week to come in and give me a hug because they could not believe how good this skiing was.
Oh, that is amazing. And what I do like about your network is that you do feel like you're coming home.
Yeah.
And you get into the warming lodge, and there's fresh-made bread, and there's soups, and it really is just an incredible feeling. And then you head out, and you can get personalized advice on where to go, beginner, intermediate, and advanced. And you guys can set them up with complete skis, poles, polks if you have a small one to, you know, slide behind you.
Two of those are already reserved today. You know,
nice.
And people are coming out. We have four of them, so hurry up and get the
other
two.
Oh, I was going to say, well, my kids are too big now. You ski on your own. But some of my best memories, actually, is going on over to Bear Notch with my little ones and putting them in that.
Yeah.
And they're eating their goldfish in there, fully enclosed, and I'm like, But getting out into that field, and we're seeing some of it right there, but just that field of the right as you cross the bridge there.
Yeah.
And that is such a fun thing, and they loved it.
It's beautiful. And the waterfall crossing we've got in, and that's, I mean, it's unbelievably nice now. It is unbelievably nice because it's been a rough winter, and people can't believe how good the base we've had is. Like yesterday, we didn't really get hardly any rain. Mm. In the end, we got a flurry.
Okay. Ah.
When I was out around 9 o'clock last night, it was flurrying out. And so it set up really quick, but it's coming out very good.
Yeah, and it tends to be that you guys don't get the rain we get down here in the village because you're kind of in this tunnel coming right off the mountain of, you know, beautiful snow conditions, and you have a lot of protected woods area. So even if it's a windy day, they can get into the woods.
Yes, and it's amazing what a couple degrees makes. Mm. You know, that's what it is, the difference between 35 and 32.
Yeah.
You know, and it's just a couple miles down the road, it changes. And it's surprising. It is a different environment, and we're very lucky to have that.
It's gorgeous.
But what I'm particularly proud of is our staff. I got to tell you, we got a staff that we've had for a lot of years. My brother's been growing with 22 of them, but Luis has been renting skis for like 20 years.
That's
and my brother's, my other brother does lessons out there. And so he does an excellent learn to ski lesson. So we like to offer that also.
All right. So when people pull into Bear Notch, let's talk about how they get to the touring center. And then what are the first steps if they need gear and a trail pass?
Yeah. Well, today we're about 3.7 miles beyond Attitash.
Just about.
Yeah. If you depend on your odometer.
Right.
So, and we'll be right on the left-hand side.
Okay.
And we did, last weekend, we had people almost parking in the road because it's so busy.
Oh, my gosh.
But this weekend, we expanded the parking lot. But the first thing you're going to do is pull in. There's going to be a white farmhouse and a red building out back. The red building out back today would be where you would go just to get tickets.
Mm-hmm.
That's also where you're going to find our homemade bread and the soups and stuff like that. And it's all on a system out there, so you just go in, and if you have your own stuff, you bring that in there. But if you're looking for rentals, and you come out front to the white building, which is where we do rentals, and Luisa or one of us will come out there, and we'll make sure you get in. We have some really nice rental equipment. People can't believe how good it is. And we go out of our way to make sure everybody gets a proper fit in their boot.
Wonderful.
So, and,
yeah,
the, and then you get trail information. You let us know what type of skiing you like, and we go over the map and say, look, this is probably what we recommend.
And what kind of skis? Is it classic, skate? What do you have?
We have both, classic and skate.
Okay, yep. And do you have lessons for both, or do you concentrate on one?
Yeah, we do. Lessons are done by reservation, you know, and today it'd be wise, and this whole week it'd be wise to call ahead.
Absolutely.
Yeah, because we only have a limited amount of instructors. But, you know, we do both lessons.
Wonderful. Well, before we let you go, can you give me a trail pick, insider's trail pick, for beginner, intermediate, and expert today?
Well, beginners, that's always going to be going down to the Scenic and Simple across the street. It brings you down to the Saco River, and that's all been freshly groomed, and it's all tracked out really nicely. So it makes it easy on even the first timer. Now, as far as an intermediate goes, you've got so many choices, it's hard. My brother and I would disagree.
Right. That's
I was over grooming Yates Farm last night, and Yates Farm is a network that we don't get open that often, and so that would be my pick.
Okay.
But I'm guessing John is going to pick probably the Bartlett Brook Loop over on Trail 42, because it's such a beautiful place. And he's out there with a bully, and that really does do a great job.
All right, maybe we should have a competition here. Yates or Trail number 42 and find out, you know, public opinion on which one is more enjoyable. I imagine they're so different, though.
You know what? You can wrap them all up in a loop anyway.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that way you can get a good opinion. Yes, so you can start out through the Village Loop, swing into Yates Farm, come around and get the Scenic and Simple on the way back.
Excellent. You guys have grown up cross-country skiing, so where do you head for the Black Diamond?
The Black Diamond, today, 19A.
19A.
Okay. It has a really steep hill, starts out innocent, but it goes into a switchback and really challenges you.
Nice. All right. So we can find more information on your website, or they can give you a call?
Yep.
All right. Well, it's great to see you again, and we're going to let you get back out. Do you have to go back out grooming, or are you going to be heading to
going out grooming.
There you go.
If not, I'll be in the rental area.
There you go.
I think today it's a challenge. We want to get as much open as we can.
I totally appreciate that, and everyone's going to appreciate that as they head out into the trail network at Bear Notch Cross Country, and that is 3.7 miles on the left, just past Attitash, and it's going to be a gorgeous day, especially as these temperatures rise.
Yes,
and
it is.
The sun is going to
be
shining.
Amazing.
Ooh, I'm going to head on over today.
We're going to make a believer out of you.
Oh, I'm already a believer. Awesome. Thanks again. Good to see you, Dan.
Yeah.
All right, folks, we'll be right back. We have more to come here on White Mountains today, so don't go away.